Hi, I'm Andrew Matlock. I am a founder and the lead designer at Designware.
And I'm Laurel Forbes. I am a designer at Designware.
Hi, Laurel. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Good. I got my coffee. It's Friday. Life is good.
It is good on a Friday.
So today we're going to talk about your kiosk project. It looks phenomenal. I can't wait to show people. So can you tell me a little bit about your design background and kind of where you came from before Designware and what you like to do traditionally?
So most of my background is in web design. Personally, I like to do all my wireframing and prototyping in Adobe XD. I've done a fair bit of front-end programming as well, so I'm very fluent in the look and feel of all the web stuff.
Yeah, you are the XD master. I only started using XD after I met you and you got the company on it. And then I threw this curveball at you. I wanted you to make a project that was going to be for some kind of a digital kiosk inside of a multi-purpose entertainment, shopping, food, real estate investment trust kind of properties. And the difficulty there was that we knew it would have to be kind of a standalone kiosk experience. It wouldn't necessarily be connected to the web. It might be like a local desktop program running full screen on a device. And we knew that device would probably have very specific dimensions. Can you tell us about the challenges building a kind of a local app in those resolutions?
The requirements for the project were pretty confined in terms of the sizing. So we had a landscape version and a portrait version, as well as a mobile version that were pretty static in size constraints. So that was the first challenge. But we also wanted to create something that was good for users to be able to find their way around and establish what stores and amenities are available on the ground.
And usually when you're making an app or website in Designware, you are accounting for all potential widths down to the pixel. Was it any different, your mentality going into this project, kind of targeting three specific widths?
No, not a lot. For the portrait and landscape modes, we tried to keep it pretty fluid so that there was no specific targeting for those ones. We minimized that as much as possible, so there was very few accommodations for each of those views.
That's awesome. We like it when it's flexible like that, and it'll make it easier for people to jump into this project template one day as well.
Exactly.
So I threw this big idea at you, which is let's make a kiosk with this fictional business. What was your favorite part of the project, the experience building it?
I had a few favorite parts. The creating the layout of the mall was actually kind of a fun task. But I think my favorite part was also my least favorite part, which was trying to figure out how to get the layouts to respond in the manner in which I intend them to. So that took a number of iterations to get it just right. But it was also my favorite. I loved troubleshooting, specifically in the layout and making sure everything's wrapping and expanding as it needed to.
If you could give anyone else a recommendation, if they are building their own kiosk interface, what would you tell them?
Layout first. Establish the layout, make sure it's functioning and wrapping and responding the way that it's intended with the major elements, but leave the smaller details to the end.
Tell me about the map. It's obviously a fictional property in this case. How did you decide where to put things, what to name them, making it look as good as it does for a static asset?
I used inspiration from other shopping malls, kind of what sort of layouts work, which doesn't. And then I manipulated it a little bit to match kind of the size that we were going for, and then shaping the interior stores to match a realistic flow of how a shopping mall would typically work.
So Laurel, can you walk us through the project? Okay, here we are in the actual editor with the Forbes Centre. So let's take a peek at portrait mode. This is landscape, obviously. That's cool. That's really cool that you figured it out that way.
Yeah, so the portrait mode is literally just the landscape mode turned on its side.
So take us through the page structure.
So we started with the map as kind of the forefront of this layout as the go-to item on a kiosk. And then we did the directory underneath. These act as buttons that will take you to a separate page to highlight what's happening in those particular areas. I'll start with the stores. So the mall directory has three floors. So this is the floor one with the overall map and layout and the floor directories. And then floors two also follow the same structure. So these respond very similar to the homepage where the map's on the left and the directory's on the right. So I'll jump up to the food and drink. So following a similar format with the map on the left with the particular food areas highlighted in red, and then just an overall kind of with a picture of what those food locations are. Most of them are kind of your fast food services with one lounge and one grill. Okay, and the office directory. There's approximately 150 offices in this little directory.
Can you go to portrait mode for this one? That's cool.
Okay, and then the hotel. So in portrait mode, we have the different rooms available on the left, and the hotel amenities on the right. So I'll take you over to the conference center. It's heavy on the visual images, highlighting what the conference center looks like and what type of events could happen there.
Okay. Oh, the cinema. Yeah, let's go to the movies.
Love the movies. With the ratings, the movie times, really everything you need to know about the movies that are playing at that time. And then we have a little feature area here for the Dark Fortune movie. And then it responds to a bit more of a portrait as well as the listing top to bottom.
Amazing. That's awesome. Well, really nice work. I love what you did.
This is a great one to work on, and I think I learned a lot from it.
Cool. Thank you for thanks for chatting today. It was really illuminating.
Thank you for having me.
Okay. Talk to you soon.
Okay. Bye.